can't hear myself. Oh, now I can hear myself. So I'm live. Okay, this is CrossCode demo exploration mode. We can start in 3, 2, 1, go. There you go. Good enough. So this is a demo to a game that is still in out. The game will be a action JRPG. We won't see much of the RPG part, and we'll see much more platforming and two big fights. It's a short demo. It's not a short demo. Wait. So it took me a few hours to complete it the first time, but with clever routing, I got it down to 15 minutes. God damn it! This worked a lot better in practice. What we're going to do is we're going to walk through this area, pick up a lot of items in blue boxes. We need to pick up all of them. I don't know how many, actually. Some of them are equipment, which is really useful. And what we're going to do first is pick up two blue weapons. Blue weapons as in blue rarity, if you've ever played an RPG. The area is kind of a loop, so you would have to do backtracking to pick up all of the stuff. So what we do in the beginning is do one of the loops, basically, and then we'll have to walk all the way back to the first fight. I picked up that one box from below. That's kind of a nice exploit you can do. The platforming. So you wouldn't think there's any platforming in this game because you don't have a jump button. The character automatically jumps at the edge of a platform. So, why do I even call it platforming? Now, there's an exploit. So the game won't let you dash. So I have a dash, obviously. It's 2017. Every game has a dash to go fast. So it won't let me do anything really, or it won't let me dash while I'm dropping or while I'm jumping. So what I do is cancel my jump animation with an attack. It only works. It also works with other things, but the attack is the most consistent one. And then, after doing that, I can do a dash, and like this, I can cover distances that are much further than what I could do with normal jumps. And not only that, not only can I go fast, I can also go around corners, because I do the attack, and then I can choose my direction for the dash, which does not have to be the same as the jump. I'm playing on keyboard and mouse, so my aiming is pretty precise, but my platforming less so because I have digital inputs. You could play this game perfectly with a controller, but then you run into the opposite problem, basically. But I'm really comfortable with keyboard and mouse for this game. Holy moly. So this extended jump, we call it... actually, everyone calls it a different thing. I call it jump dash because it's a jump and then a dash. It's really strict timing. You can mess it up. Depending on your timing, you go further or less. So it's definitely a skill you have to learn. It's not trivial. Oops. So this is an RPG. We have abilities we're gonna activate. One of them gives us more attack. The other one is a special attack you'll be seeing a lot of. And this is gear we picked up or got in the beginning. So this is my special attack. It does a lot of damage, but it also cancels the charges of these enemies. So it's my favorite one, at least for this category of the game.
We just got a $1 donation from Matze saying, who is running a beta game? Oh wait. And we just got another $10 donation by Swindleary saying, Ethexy, I saw you smile hearing... There was a donation. Were you thinking I was the one behind it, Kappa? Do you have any other runs scheduled? At commentator, hi.
I didn't listen at all. this fight is really hard. There's a lot of enemies. It's kind of RNG because enemies are activated when you kill one. When you attack one enemy. Oh, I didn't. I need to die. When you attack one enemy, the ones in the vicinity are also activated. So depending on how they are standing, you can get a lot of them at once, or just a few. It's fast to do all at once, but it's really risky. Now, the Comet also has two really great exploits. One of them is the attack cancel. You can cancel an attack animation by performing a dash. The game is supposed to be really fluid, and it really is. You can cancel things and go from one action to the other really easily. Also, I have items to heal myself. Oops. By doing the cancel, why is this not working now? Oh, I'm in my element. By canceling your attack, you can immediately launch another attack. So instead of going through a full combo of melee attacks, you just do the first attack over and over again by just spamming left click and right click on the keyboard. It's harder on controller, I've heard. I don't play this on controller. And you can actually even attack that so fast that the enemy won't do any attacks. Okay, we killed a few enemies here. We got a level up, and then the boss enemy appeared. This is not enough to skill anything. It's a blue hedgehog. Think of that what you will. There's another combat exploit. So, the game has elements. The demo has not implemented them a lot, so there are no special attacks for the other elements that are in here. However, if you switch to fire element, I fucking died. If you switch to fire element, you get a lot of attack. So, it's not worth it, really, because the special attack is much better still. But someone found that if you start an elemental attack and then switch to... if you start a special attack and then switch to the fire element, your stat boost will still count and you will have a very, very effective attack. And I keep forgetting to switch my back to my neutral element to do the special attack, so I'm tanking a lot of damage here. Oh, I need to kill an enemy still. There you go. I have an SP bar, which needs filling up by attacking people, so I can perform more special attacks. If I run out of, like, if I perform special attacks without attacking anyone normally, I run out of them. Okay, so now I'm down to just this one, and it should be really easy. Whenever he charges, I can do my special attack. It'll get canceled. And I switch to my element to get more damage. If I were to attack another hedgehog now, they would join the fight. I really don't want to do that. So, the reason I'm killing this enemy is he spawns an item that I need to complete the game. I need all the items to complete the game. Oh my god, holy moly, that was really fast. You can't spam heal items, you can use them every 10 seconds. Okay, that's that, finally. He spawns the best weapon in the game, the Winter Claw. which I'll need later. Upcoming is a platforming section, and then we walk into the boss fight, into a boss fight. So this is actually my first ever speed game. I didn't even think of speedrunning, really. The demo was just released for this game's crowdfunding campaign, and it was just really, 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 really good. And I wanted to play more of it, so I decided to, like, I've seen many speedruns, and I said, well, let's get some replay value out of this. And it takes some time to explore all of the mechanics, especially the combat, but also the platforming. I kept finding, like, over the course of months, I kept finding that you could jump further and further and do more amazing jumps, get to places you that you're not supposed to. So, yeah, you can tell I'm kind of new to speedrunning because my first speed game is still not out. So yeah, every time you see me just perform an attack and then a dash, you can tell it's a jump you're not supposed to do. The developers knew about this. They thought it was funny, and they left it in. It's still in the game, they will keep it, apparently. This jump is really tricky. You won't need to jump around a corner. There you go. Otherwise, you would have to walk around and do some jumps. They also knew about the attack cancel, I think, and they also decided to leave it in. To be honest, I wasn't very happy about it. It's really... if it really turns out to be the most effective way to deal damage, which I think it is, it really hurts after a while. It's a lot of mashing. This screen has some... this screen is really optimized. So you can... there's a few ways to go about this. I'll do the easy one. And then here's a jump. You can't even see it, so you have to get a feeling for where the edge is, and that's where you jump. Otherwise, you would have to walk around that that hole and those enemies. And yeah, I'm ignoring all the enemies. In the beginning, I used to try to get some cheap kills with my special attack on the way. Turns out you really don't need to once you're somewhat good, and you can clear the game with basically only minimal experience that you have to get. You can even... that first long fight that I did, that I died on, you can do it with just rookie equipment, the one you get in the very beginning, without picking up good weapons. It's possible. I did it, and it turned out to be a lot slower than just getting better equipment, because you deal next to no damage. This jumping puzzle goes over two rooms, actually. You couldn't tell. There was a skip in it. There are a few skips in it by doing these jump dashes. And now it's time to equip all the stuff we've got and use some of our experience points. So what we got? Pick mask, winter claw, this one we keep, assault vest, and feline paws. Obviously I only go for equipment that which gives me a lot of attack. And I missed an item. This worked a lot better in practice. So I was kind of informed on short notice that I was allowed to do this run. And I did one practice run and it was fine. Mm-hmm. And there's no way to tell which items you've got or not. I have this one, I have the one on the top. Oh, this is a train wreck. Oh, I think I have an idea. Oops. There we go. The Master Ball. A useless item in the demo. I don't know whether it's still useless in the actual game. Now, the actual game, this is just one area out of the game. There's a lot more of these, and there's a lot of quests and stuff like that, a lot of dialogue. It's a JRPG. So, the actual game, someone does runs of them, someone named X-Dragon. Shoutouts. Thanks for donating $2,000. That's a lot. The horn. This is a boss fight, I hope I can do it. Well, there's no horn, so I can keep talking. The whole run, I think the whole game will be about 2 hours or less.
So you may have already noticed the clapping just now. We just hit $2,000. Oh my God. We just got an $18 anonymous donation saying 2K hype at Swindleery. Yes, it was. And nope, no more runs from me. And don't worry, though, because there is still plenty of cool runs coming up.
Okay, so in that boss fight, apparently you one cycle it by just spamming special attacks. Kind of forgot about it. Now we're just going up to the final challenge of the demo. After picking up all the items, two of which are keys, the last one we just got from the boss fight, we unlock this challenge and we get actually our last item in the game. So, oops, that's kind of the category, get all this stuff. Or get the one at the end, for which you need all the stuff. We should have some more experience now. So there's one special attack rewind. And actually this, okay, I don't have all that much experience apparently. Okay, let's go. So this is kind of an enemy rush type of thing. Holy moly. The patterns are always the same. So, once you learn it, like, I forgot most of it apparently, but you can go pretty fast by just standing at the right spot, doing this, the right special attacks when everyone is spawning. In the beginning, I don't really need them because the enemies are weak, but some harder ones will be coming up. Which I think these need a special attack, and then this is an exploit that was taken out of the game. You can shoot these guys, they charged an attack. I messed that up. These guys can only be attacked from behind. There you go. So those mole enemies are really nice in the demo. Usually they always stay away from you when you get close. And when they charge an attack, You have the chance to shoot them. They get like this. They don't move for a moment, and then you have time to just dash at them, take them out quickly with melee. They took it out of the game. I'm not happy about it. So we'll see this again. Come on. Okay. I didn't charge the shot. Oh yeah, I forgot there's charge shots. They bounce. And they do more damage, and they're really useful. These bolts I can only kill with one special attack by doing the exploit with the fire element. I don't remember the phase. Alright. When you attack this enemy right away, missing label, this is a bug. When you attack this enemy right away, you can kill him before his shield starts up. And now, I don't even know how to deal with him. There we go. These enemies are on a timer. And we're close to the end. I can take this also out with a special attack as well, obviously. I keep, when you charge a shot and then you move your mouse, you lose the charge, and I keep doing this by mistake. So I need to release first, and then there you go. And these are the last three enemies. You might know one of them. Or remember them. And that's... when I take up the box on the bottom, when I click on it, that's time. Time. Okay, I was very rusty, but that's CrossCode demo. It's very different from the main game. So I really enjoy playing it a lot still. Thanks for letting me play it.